After President Trump's address to the nation, Democratic Socialist Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez slams ICE.
The president should not be asking for more money to an agency that has systematically violated human rights. The president should be really defending why we are funding such an agency at all. Because right now, what we are seeing is death. Right now, what we are seeing is the violation of human rights.
Joining us right now with his reaction is the former acting ICE director at Fox News contributor now, Tom Homan. Tom, this must just have you steamed.
Well, you know, it's incredible. I mean, every time she opens her mouth, she's wrong. I mean, I suppose she went to college in Boston. She must be an embarrassment to that institution. She needs to do her homework. First of all, no child died in ICE custody. That was a different agency. That was the Border Patrol. And they did everything they could to save that child's life. All right? That child's in bad shape. You want to blame somebody for deaths in custody? Then blame the Democrats who refuse to close the loopholes that cause these families to come in the first place. When you talk about human rights violations, does she realize that ICE has arrested and removed hundreds of human rights violators from this country, including Nazis and people that committed war crimes in certain parts of Europe? We actually arrest a lot of human rights violators. And she ought to be saying thank you. She's from New York. ICE agents have arrested and removed thousands of criminals from the streets of New York that were released from sanctuary jails that she supports. So a thank you would be nice rather than misinformation that she always puts out.
Well, and as you have said in the past, the ICE agents are simply enforcing the laws that Congress enacted. So if you got a problem with it, go to Congress. There's something else that caught our eye this morning, Tom, and that is the Center for Immigration Studies has done an analysis, and they have figured out the cost of each illegal immigrant here in the United States. Over a lifetime, it's $82,191 per lifetime per illegal crosser, which is actually more than the annual median income here in the United States, which is $61,000. And the argument, and the president has made this in the past, is if we could stop the illegal immigration, the wall would essentially pay for itself by stopping the people who are a drain on society, he would say.
Well, absolutely. I said it the other day on the network. I said, you know, $5 billion is nothing. This wall will pay for itself in a matter of a couple of years because less illegal immigration means less detention costs, which is ICE's budget is like $8 billion a year. It will be less detention costs, less immigration court costs, less circuit court costs, less social services being used by illegal alien families that come in. Because you got to remember, the illegal families come in, they have a U.S. citizen child, first thing they do is go to social services. So, you know, the cost of illegal immigration, there's been several studies, is as high as $120 billion a year. So the wall would pay for itself just from the cost savings from illegal immigration being slowed and decreased.
They also say in that study, if they bring in children or grandchildren, it can cost Americans anywhere between $94,000 and $104,000 per illegal immigrant over the course of their lifetime. I know you sat down with the president before his Oval Office address. What did you guys talk about?
I had a meeting, you know, I did a meeting at the White House, and, you know, I talked to the president pretty occasionally, but My thoughts to the White House were this. I said, you know, I'm glad the president's doing the address to the nation. You know, Nancy and Chuck refused to listen to a security briefing by the secretary. Senate confirmed secretary wanted to give them a state of address on what's going on the border. They refused to hear the data. So I said on this network, the president needs to go straight to the American people and give them the data that Chuck and Nancy refused to hear, because this data is real. And this isn't a manufactured crisis. I mean, we've seen the caravan, and I implore to share with American people the facts and talk about effectiveness of the wall. And I think the president did a great job last night. I think the rebuttal by the Democrats was embarrassing, to say this is a manufactured crisis. We all saw the caravans. Yeah. I mean, we've heard the children that died. We've seen what's going on the border. To say it's manufactured is ridiculous.
Tom, every time they say that these barriers, these walls, these fences don't work, they're really calling you a liar. Because what you've done and seen over decades working up close and personal, you say they absolutely do work. You both can't be right. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, thank you for that, because you know what? That was one thing that stood out to me last night. She said it once. Schumer said it twice. Ineffective wall. So either they're outright lying about this, or they're not reviewing the data that's available. Every place a border barrier has been built, every place, illegal immigration has went down, drug smuggling has went down. You know what they said last night, they care about border security. Listen to what they said. Everything they said is about improving technology at the port of entry, which is important. But then talk about what happens between the ports of entry. The one thing she said is that they're going to fund innovation to detect unauthorized crossings. I mean, what the hell is that? She can't even say the word illegal alien. She can't even admit to the fact that entering this country illegally is a crime. It's not an unauthorized crossing. It's a crime. We don't want to detect it. We want to stop it. And the way you stop it is with a wall and with additional Border Patrol personnel, which we clearly show in San Diego. When the caravan is rushing the border, they would have been staying in San Diego today if it wasn't for that border barrier and the men and women of the Border Patrol standing there.
What you have is political free statements, and all they are doing is playing politics. Tom Holman, thanks so much.
Thank you.